Younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze, country roads, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia.
John Knowles was born in the town of Fairmont, West Virginia on September 16, 1926. He was the son of the vice president of a major coal mining company there. When he was 15, he left home and enrolled at Phillips Exeter Academy, a preppy boarding school in New Hampshire. This created his love of the New England region. It would also help him write some of his books, especially A Separate Piece. When he first started going to PEA, World War II had just broken out and the U.S. had joined him by declaring war on Japan. After he graduated, he and many other boys like him enrolled in the military and fought in the war. He trained to become a pilot for the U.S. Air Force. He decided to go back to school at Yale to get his bachelor's degree after the war. At Yale, he worked as an editor for the Yale Daily News and later as a reporter for the Hartford Courant for 3 years. Throughout the 50s, John had traveled all over Europe as a journalist. He worked on lots of short stories while in Europe. When he returned to the United States, he became an associate editor at a magazine company. He wasn't very happy with this job, so he asked for advice about what to do with his life. With some help, especially from Foreign Wilder, John began to work on a novel. While in Europe, John wrote two short stories, Phineas and A Turn in the Sun. These two stories would come together to create his greatest masterpiece, A Separate Piece. A Separate Piece, which was published in the U.S. in 1960, became a huge success. This led John to quit his job and start writing more books. He wrote 8 other books during his career, but none of them compared to A Separate Piece. He became a writer in residence at both Princeton University and the University of North Carolina. He received many awards like the Rosenthal Foundation Award and Faulkner Foundation Award. John passed away in Fort Lauderdale, Florida on November 29, 2001 at the age of 75. There are many important themes in A Separate Piece. The most important theme, in my opinion, is identity. In the book, the main characters are high school students. This time of adolescence is scary for most teens since you begin to start wondering what you want to do later in life. It's also when teens struggle to figure out who they really are and what their interests are. When teens begin to question who they really are, they start to make themselves become popular. For example, Gene begins to make himself more like Finney since Finney is athletic and popular. This isn't who Gene is, however. This change in Gene also makes their friendship worse since Gene begins to have the same feel for rivalry and competition as Finney. John talks about this theme throughout the book to teach kids to be themselves. Trying to change who you are just makes things worse. There are also lots of examples of symbolism throughout the book. Biggest one to me was Finney's broken leg. The rivalry that begins to grow between Gene and Finney causes Finney to break his leg. This symbolizes their broken friendship. Finney tries to be optimistic by thinking that this will make this relationship stronger. But it does the opposite. He believes that his leg will be stronger by the time it heals, but it ends up becoming weaker than before. This symbolizes their friendship becoming worse and worse throughout the book. Just because you experience hardship doesn't mean things will begin to get better in your friendship. You have to fix it and make it good again. John uses a symbol in the book to talk about his early struggles with friendship. He felt out of place and alone at Exeter, so he tried everything he could to make new friends. As he made new friendships, his issues with identity began to make these friendships fall apart. John wanted to teach readers that it's important to just be yourself in a relationship and do everything you can to make it better.
John Knowles has made a huge impact on the writing community and has changed so many lives with the themes of his books. We don't know what we'd do without John Knowles. Thank you for listening to my podcast, and I can't wait to read A Separate Piece. Adios.